Hello, welcome to this short video introducing the new XJTAG DFT assistant for Altium Designer, a free software extension for Altium Designer that adds design for test capabilities when implementing JTAG boundary scan in a PCB. To install the extension, go to Extensions and Updates. If it isn't already installed, you'll see the XJTAG logo. To install, simply click on the download icon or install from the detailed overview page. You'll need to restart Altium to complete the install. To start using the DFT assistant, load a project. Once loaded, open the DFT assistant from the view menu or by clicking on the XJTAG logo in the toolbar. The assistant's now running, and the user interface is docked on the left-hand side of the screen. Let's start using the assistant's design for test features. We start by generating the netlist for the current design. This imports the Altium netlist and BOM data. Zooming in on the schematic, we can see that IC1 is a JTAG-enabled device. To make use of the JTAG tap or test access port, you'll need to obtain the BSDL file, or Boundary Scan Description Language file. You can get the BSDL file from the device manufacturer. Verify that the device revision and package are correct. Save the BSDL file in your Altium project directory. To assign a BSDL file to a JTAG device, open the Add JTAG Device dialog box. Start typing the designator into the device window to see a list of possible matching device designators. Once a device is selected, we can browse for the correct BSDL file to assign. The file gives the assistant the information it needs to include the device in the boundary scan chain and specifies the test access built into the device's I/O pins. The BSDL file must be the correct one for the device. The next step is to define a boundary scan chain by defining the board entry and exit points, in this case via JTAG test connector CN1, so that the assistant can check the chain from start to finish. We do this by using the Add Chain dialog box. Give the chain a name. You can type the test connector identifier directly or select it from a list of connectors. For example, under Suggested Connectors, the connector signals are displayed below, from where we can select the entry point for TDI and the exit point for TDO. This process can be repeated for up to 4 boundary scan chains in a single design. When a chain signal routes through a passive device, we need to tell the assistant how the chain routes through that device. Here, for example, R37 would block the chain, causing DFT assistant to flag a tap connection error. To define how to route through a passive device, use the Categorize Passive Devices dialog. We can find R37 either in the All category or in Suggested Series Resistors. Assign a .pdd or Passive Device Descriptor file to it, the same as BSDL files are assigned to JTAG devices. Having defined a completed JTAG chain to assistant, we can run Check Chain. The assistant checks the chain and a dialog box reports the results. Tap Connections OK confirms the chain is complete, but tap Terminations don't yet meet DFT guidelines. Compliance Pins OK means all compliant pins are connected appropriately. At any point in your design process, click on Show JTAG Access to view the extent of boundary scan access overlaid on your schematic diagram. It's a really powerful feature of the assistant. See exactly which nets are accessible to boundary scan. This allows you to make design changes or corrections to maximize the boundary scan access in a design. For example, IC2 is also a JTAG-enabled device, and we'll be able to increase the test coverage if we either insert IC2 into chain 1 or, as we'll do next, create a new chain for IC2. First, as before, let's assign a BSDL file to IC2. The board already has the connectivity for a second chain. As before, a series resistor that would block the chain needs to be categorized. There's no need to do these steps in a particular order, so this time I'll categorize R38 before creating the second chain. I can check both series resistors are categorized by clicking on View Categorized Devices. Now I'll add the second chain, which I'll call chain 2. I need to specify entry and exit points for the new chain. The signals on CN1 have been meaningfully named. So it's easy to find the right ones in the drop-down list. Check chain shows basic chain connectivity is good. Hide and unhide the JTAG access to refresh the screen. See how adding IC2 as a JTAG device has given us many more JTAG accessible signals, which will undoubtedly improve our test coverage. A separate window displays a key for highlighted signals. Quite a few signals have gone from grey, no access, to green, meaning full read-write access. And that's as a result of adding IC2 as a JTAG device. Returning now to termination issues, a new error has appeared referencing the test reset signal. Unlike IC1, the IC2 JTAG port requires the test reset signal. Categorizing JP5 completes the circuit for test reset. Passive device descriptors or .pdd files are easy to create within the assistant, but here I'll use one link.pdd, which I created earlier. Let's do another check chain. So now we have three errors remaining, along with some warnings. Let's address the errors first. I've made the required changes to the schematic by adding 10K pull-ups to the TDO signals, so they are fully compliant with XJTAG DFT guidelines. The TCK signal requires a blocking capacitor in series with a terminating resistor. I've also categorized JP4. Note that whenever you change the schematic, you must save and compile it in Altium, then regenerate the netlist. Let's use check chain again to see what issues remain. Now we have only two warnings. The series terminating resistors for the TDO signals have only very slightly higher resistance than the DFT guidelines recommend, so these warnings can be ignored. Once the schematic diagram is complete and verified, and the JTAG tap has been checked by the assistant, you can hand off the project to XJDeveloper for further test development. This is done using the export button. The export function is only enabled if a valid license for XJDeveloper is found. Usually this means plugging in an XJLink 2 supplied with every license by XJTAG or one of its distributors. XJTAG offers a free 30-day trial. You can apply for the free trial online by clicking on the Get Started Now button. We'll send you an XJLink 2 controller and a download link. The XJDeveloper software has comprehensive tutorials and the trial license lasts for a full 30 days, which can be extended by request. We'll even help you set up your first board, either in our lab or we can walk you through it via a web call. If you have the XJDeveloper license via an XJLink 2, connect the XJLink 2 to your PC using the USB provided. Then click Retry. OK the .xjd file name and save your XJDeveloper project. The assistant reports XJDeveloper project exported OK. That's it. Thanks for watching.